Thanks to an update last night, every single PlayStation game and exclusive is now playable on iOS mobile phones and tablets. Is this the streaming future that everybody has feared come to PlayStation? Well, kind of, but not really. Sort of. Let's talk about it, shall we? What's going on, guys? RandellThor19, Man with the Million, back again with another video. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and hit that subscribe button if you are new. I greatly appreciate it. So what are we talking about today? PlayStation exclusives on your mobile phone? Does that mean you don't need a reason to buy PlayStations anymore? Oh my god, the fanboys are going out of their minds. Let me kind of rein it in, bring some logic and facts into the discussion. So what exactly has happened? So late last night, Sony released PS4 firmware update 6.5, and the biggest new feature it added is remote play functionality for your iPhones and your iPads to take your PlayStation experience, your PlayStation exclusive and games on the go, mobile style. Well, not really truly mobile, and I'm gonna explain that in just a minute here. So it's pretty easy to set up. You turn on your PlayStation, you download the remote play app from the iOS store, you pair the two on the same in-home Wi-Fi network, and you're good to go. You could enjoy God of War while in the bathroom. If somebody's using your TV to watch a movie, you know what? The fun doesn't need to end. You can take out your iPad and start playing Spider-Man. Sounds pretty damn cool. But unfortunately, one of the biggest drawbacks of this whole situation is that DualShock 4 isn't supported. They basically put touchscreen controls on top of the actual image on your phone, whether you're playing horizontal or vertical, and it doesn't really control very well, judging by some of the impressions and videos I've seen of people actually playing it. Yeah, you can play Apex Legends on the phone instead of your console now if you wanted to, but why would you want to, especially with those touchscreen controls? It's pretty horrible, but maybe eventually Sony updates it and lets you actually use your DualShock 4. That would be something to hope for. Now, this isn't really a truly mobile solution, and you still need PlayStation hardware to pull this all off. I know, you know, the talk, and I've seen some videos where you're like, oh my god, PlayStation exclusives, they're gone. They're on mobile phones now forever. Well, at least right now, that's not the case. To even get this working, you still need PlayStation 4 hardware in your house. This isn't like xCloud, which would let you get it without hardware, but we'll talk about that in a minute. This is mobile streaming or remote play, but it's not really truly mobile. And this is something Sony's been doing for some time anyways, and they were doing remote play functionality with the Vita, but the Vita was actually a gaming device with great controls, just like the Switch. People actually loved using it. I'm not really sure many people are going to be enjoying playing God of War with those terrible touchscreen controls. But it's not really a truly mobile solution. It's like half in, half out. Like, Sony still wants people to buy their PlayStation hardware and not go full streaming. You see, you need to be on the same home network. So if your PlayStation's at home and you're traveling or on your lunch break at work, you can't just fire up your iPhone and get a couple rounds of Fortnite in or play Ghost of Tsushima or like Devil May Cry 5 because you're not on the same network. So it's not truly a mobile solution, and you do have to wonder why, you know, anybody would really want to use it. You gotta be in the same Wi-Fi network. So it's like, it's only gonna be used for some of those scenarios I talked about. You're on the shitter? Okay, maybe you can play, if you know, 20 minutes of God of War. Somebody's using the TV? Okay, well, you can play Spider-Man on your iPad, right? It's not really truly next-level streaming, and you still require the PlayStation hardware. So it's kind of like half in. Sony's got their foot, you know, they're testing out the water. Ooh, it's a little bit too cold. Don't want to jump all the way in. Don't want to fully commit just yet. Even though we've seen job listings saying that they want to bring console quality games to every device sometime in the future, this isn't exactly it. And maybe this is just getting people used to the idea of PlayStation games on iOS. Right now, it's remote streaming. Right now, you need PlayStation 4 hardware, but who knows what the future entails. And then when you compare this to what Microsoft is currently doing or planning on doing with xCloud, it's not really the same thing. You see, xCloud is going to give you the ability to play Xbox games and Xbox exclusives without the need of Xbox hardware. So while you're at work, you can connect to your Xbox account and play the games that you purchased. If you're on your lunch break and you want to play Apex and all those different things, right? Currently, you can't do that with this. There you go, PlayStation fans. PS4 hardware still needed to play all those great PlayStation exclusives. This is not a truly mobile streaming solution like Microsoft is aiming for. And I do have to wonder if or when Sony will go that route. You know, PlayStation 5 is going to be upon us real soon. Horizon Zero Dawn 2, Spider-Man 2, God of War 2, a slew of great new games for Sony to help sell the PlayStation 5. But as everybody has been saying, and all these tech companies are getting in, streaming is going to be more important to get your games and your name and your brand and your ecosystem in the hands of more people than you could possibly imagine. You know, PlayStation currently is, what, almost at 100 million consoles sold for the PlayStation 4? And I always kind of think of the scene in The Social Network. You know what's cooler than $1 million? About $1 billion. And these companies are always searching for more money. More money for their investors so they can drive up their stock prices and increase their portfolios and their, you know, stock benefits and their salaries. So you can imagine all these people, all these executives looking at it and be like, well, why sell 120 million consoles when we could sell to billions of gamers, right? So I do wonder if at some point, I don't know when it's going to happen, if Sony does allow the PlayStation hardware not to be as forefront as it is right now. If they do let you to play all those great exclusives without needing to buy PlayStation 5. You know, you have to look at Google entering the market. What are they going to do with their streaming service? What is Microsoft going to do? What are all these companies that are building these infrastructures to stream games? And you're Sony. I do have to wonder if they're going to be kind of sitting at the sidelines hoping that game streaming isn't what people want, or are they quietly working on their own solution, maybe partnering up with somebody else like Amazon to build their own network to make sure that they're not left behind? Because in the future of game streaming, what's going to be the great divide? What will you pick? Why go with Microsoft? Why go with Google? Why go with Amazon or Apple? It'll come down to the games on offer. Who has the better service and who has the better prices? And right now, you go on Metacritic, you talk to, you know, the fanboys, and I'll admit it readily myself, the Sony exclusives are right now way better on a different level than Microsoft and Nintendo's. Will that always remain the case? Who knows what the future holds? Microsoft has invested a ton of money in new studios, for new content, for their console, and their streaming. But I do have to wonder if Sony sees the writing on the wall, and this is just the first step. Even though it's not a truly mobile solution, even though it's really not going to be great to play because it's just touchscreen controls on a phone, you need to have that DualShock 4 solution, that this is just the first step of many steps leading to the point where God of War 2 comes out, you buy it, and you can play it on your PlayStation hardware. Maybe you can play it on your PC. And if you do have iOS, you can play it on your phone or your iPad. The future is going to be really interesting. Can't wait for next gen to come. I want to see what all these different companies are going to do. But in the meantime, that is what is going on with Sony. Let me know how Remote Play works for you guys if you do decide to actually try it out. I am interested in seeing if the controls are actually as horrible as I have read. But in the meantime, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like. Share this out on social media like Twitter and Facebook. Make sure to tell a friend about the channel. I would greatly appreciate it. Hit that sub button if you're new, and hit that notification bell if you always want to be notified when I immediately upload new content. Thank you guys so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it, and I'll see everybody in the next video. Later, guys.